Oh, I am ready for the storm. Yes, so ready. I am ready for the storm. I'm ready for the storm.
Hey folks, Okieprepper here. Hey, I've been getting a lot of emails and private messages and comments about my video on water purification, and it seems like a lot of the questions are answered in the video, and people aren't really paying attention to what I said. And I want to make sure you understand that that we're purifying water with stock chlorine, a chemical mixture of pool shock and water to create stock chlorine that we put into the water to purify it. You know, chlorine escapes water as a gas. So if you have your water purified with stock chlorine and it's covered, it should be good. Water should be clear, without algae. You may or may not smell the chlorine in there. It really just depends on where you're at in the process, your time stored, so to speak. If you don't smell chlorine in your water after a few months, don't be alarmed. This tank has had, we're on our 20th week here with this tank after its first filling in this treatment with the stock chlorine. And we're going to pour some of that out today and test it, see what we have after 20 weeks of storage. And you know, you can kind of be on this whole experiment with me. All the information I got from reliable sources, all the survivor sites, even, you know, swimming pool sites, .gov, all your government, FEMA, researched all that, even though I know they're probably just lying to us. Somebody asked me, why didn't I use bleach? Okay, well, bleach has a shelf life of 6 months, so unless I'm storing water and changing it out every 6 months, probably don't want to make the expense of using bleach. I know bleach is cheap by the gallon, and probably wouldn't take a whole lot of the bleach to treat that, but the little bag that you saw in the video, I mean, that treats 10,000 gallons, and it doesn't degrade like bleach does. Today we're gonna pour some of that water out and test it, and join in on the experiment, and I hope we answer some questions with this video. Okay, all right. We've got our container, got our water spout. We're going to crank this valve open and fill it up. Now this is the first water coming out of this in 20 weeks. Okay, the water's looking pretty clear. Absolutely no smell at all. Okay, now we're up here at the top of the tank. I got the blinds open just so we have some ambient light here, and you can kind of see. I am going to show you the water at the top. Because this is an experiment for me. I know I'm just practicing at this. I don't declare to be a professional water purifier. So I want you to know that this is all practice for me too. And I'm going to take a little simple green here, 1-to-1 solution, and clean the top off before I open up the cap. Make sure all this is clean. All your dust. Okay, I do want to make one observation here for you. This is not an airtight cap. It does have a valve in the top of it right here that enables, basically, when I drop the valve down there open, that the water will come down without it causing a vacuum in here. So I do have to come up in here periodically and add just a little bit of water. Now you can see there's a water line, and I got the blinds open, like I say, so you can see exactly where we're at. As you can see on the tank, there's no algae growth. There's airspace. There's the water line. Okay, so I'm gonna open up the top cap, and we're gonna take a good look at that water from the top. I'll even try to pull some out of there, and we'll get a look at that and test it as well. All right, here we go. We're all cleaned up. Cellophane. I don't know how well this will look. We shall try. Give me 1 second here. Man, would I hate to drop that camera now. All right. I don't really know how well that's gonna come off. All right, as you can see, all the way to the bottom there, there's the valve at the very bottom. This tank's like 8 foot tall, but that water is crystal clear. I don't see any algae growth on the sides. That's what we're looking for. All right, that dark shading down there, you can see at the bottom, that's where water, after I poured some out, has actually gotten underneath the tank. That's why there's different discoloration at the bottom. But this water, I'm going to shake it up a little bit so you can see the top. There you go. Water's right to the top. Again, there it is. There's your water line. Okay, we're going to let our water set for 3 hours. And then we're going to aerate it and drink it. All right. Okay, our first hour, we just completed that. 6:45, see you at 7:45. All right, coming up on hour number two. And I had some other noses in the room. And the consensus is there is a little bit of chlorine in there. They said, two people have said, it smells a little bit like city water chlorination. So I guess my old Okie olfactory nerve is not working that good. Anyway. Okay, it's been 3 hours. It's time to do the deed. I reoxygenate the water. Pretty clear. Maybe just a tinge of chlorinated smell. Oh yeah, that's some of that Southern Oklahoma well water right there. Okay. Tastes like water. Still living. Yep, still got a pulse. All right, we'll check back in an hour and see if I'm still breathing.
Squad 51, stand by for response.
Squad 51, 10-4.
Send me some EKG. 10-4, transmitting EKG. We're sending you a strip. Vitals to follow. Pulse is 160. The victim is in extreme pain, Rampart.
The station is in V5. Rampart, we have lost the victim's pulse. Beginning CPR. We're defibrillating victim, Rampart. Rampart, we've defibrillated victim. He's in sinus rhythm.
Administer 2 amps sodium bicarbonate. Insert an airway.
Start just kidding. V51.
Squad 51, continue monitoring vitals and transport immediately.